From BYU Broadcasting's performance studio, this is Highway 89. I'm Stephen Cap Perry. Church is a place where a lot of good things happen, but if you were to name five good things that come from going to church, we wouldn't blame you for accidentally leaving the establishment of a long-standing community jazz band off the list. That, however, is exactly the story we bring you today on Highway 89. Directed by Dick Landerman, the reunion band was formed more than 15 years ago at a church gathering made of mostly members of the local congregation. Over a decade and a half, the band's reach has spread. It's now made up of musicians young and old from all over the place and prides itself on being an organization designed to give young players a chance to hone their chops on big band music. We've got the reunion band in the studio with us, 17 players ready to thrill us with just a few of the 300 tunes they know together. We'll spend an hour or so in music and conversation, but we'll kick it off with one we know you'll know. Here's At Last, right here on Highway 89. Live on Highway 89, we're listening to the reunion band, chatting with the director, Dick Landerman. Dick, introduce us to the group. Tell us about the group we're hearing here.
Well, it's an eclectic bunch. Old guys like me and young guys like our third trombone player, Spencer Young. He's a senior in high school. We are proud to say that we've been sort of the launching pad for several young musicians over the years.
Some of you could probably claim that you played this music when it was the hottest thing.
Some of this music's older than dirt, and I don't want to say that
okay.
we're quite that old, but yeah, Point taken.
All I know is I have a father who ran away at age 17 to play in a big band. So
good for him.
It's been
good for him.
And it didn't seem to do him any worse for the time he spent touring around playing the trombone. You consider this a community project. What does that mean exactly to you?
Music has given us so much in our own lives, and we wanted to give back to the community. Trying to make a living as a musician in Salt Lake City is a pretty tough proposition. The money just ain't there. And so we don't do this for the money. We do it because we love to play. We love to see other people happy. We like to see people coming into the ballroom and dancing and enjoying singing in each other's ears while they dance and then holding hands as they leave.
We've got so many tunes that I know our listeners are going to recognize and maybe have to hop up and dance around in the kitchen while they listen. Tell us about these next couple.
Angel Eyes, next one up. This is kind of a sultry number featuring Craig Herzog on trombone solo. It was originally recorded in the late 1950s, early 1960s by Frank Sinatra with the Nelson Riddle Orchestra. This is a little bit different arrangement. And then after that, we've got Hot Toddy that comes to us from the 1940s over in England, the great Ted Heath Orchestra. This one features Jacob Young on baritone sax. The band does a little bit of hand clapping.
Dick Landerman is the director of the reunion band that we're hearing. We're about to hear Angel Eyes and Hot Toddy from these guys.
Thank you.
coming to you live from Studio 6. This is Highway 89. We're listening to the reunion band. We just heard Angel Eyes and Hot Toddy. Dick Landerman, director of the group. We mentioned one of the important things about this is introducing young players to this kind of music for the first time. Have you seen some of those young players go on and keep an interest in big band music?
Of course, yeah. Two of our alums were twin brothers that started with us several years ago, Derek and Dallas Crane, who are music students now at BYU. They both played with Synthesis, the jazz group here at BYU, and have gone on to major in music. Dallas is a very successful composer and arranger, and Derek has chosen to go into music education.
Nice, nice. And I understand there's some family members here in the band tonight.
There are several. There's a lot of cross-breeding, so to speak, here. Dave Young, our bass player, he's the father of two boys in the band. Jacob, who plays baritone sax, that we just heard the solo on Hot Toddy. And then Spencer, his younger brother, plays trombone. And then we have Harold Ethington, trumpet. Harold and I go way back to a little town called Yuba City in Northern California. We played in a dance band together in the 50s in high school and found each other again. Harold's son, Jared Ethington, plays alto sax with us. And then we have the Meyer family. Rick is the patriarch. He plays tenor sax. Probably heard his solo on one of the tunes we just recently played. His son is standing right beside him. Ethan also plays tenor sax and alto sax and baritone sax. And he also sings. He's a vocalist as well. Beautiful voice. And then Cindy is our, we can now say it because she allows us, she's our chick singer.
Okay.
Formerly known as the female vocalist. Did I miss anyone? I think I've covered all the family members here.
You know, it's interesting because when I'm listening for a big band and I want to know if they're real, I always listen for the sax section. And you've got five. You've got all those voices covered for those great harmonies on the different sections. Really fun to hear. We've got four trombones, two trumpets, stand-up bass, guitar, singer, drummer, pianist, and then all those saxophones. So it's a really great sound. Thanks for bringing into us.
Thank you.
Tell us about these next tunes we're going to hear.
The next tune we're going to hear is called Smoke Gets in Your Eyes. It's an old, old standard tune, but this one has a little bit of a bossa nova flavor. Comes to us by way of Brazil. That is going to feature Mike Smith, our other trumpet player, who also doubles on flugelhorn. This is arranged for a flugelhorn solo. Flugelhorn, if you don't know, is kind of an overweight trumpet. Needs to go on a diet. And then after that, we're going to feature Cindy again on a Count Basie tune called Making Whoopee. And don't worry, Mom and Dad, this is the family version. And then we're going to end up that set with the Errol Garner tune from the 1960s, Misty.
That's a great set. Thank you very much. We're listening to the band I wish was my community band here on Highway 89. We'll start off with Smoke Gets in Your Eyes.
What you get, folks, for making Whoopee. But don't forget, folks, that's what you get, folks, for making Whoopee.
I get Misty just holding your hand. We've just heard a set of three songs, Misty, Making Whoopee, and Smoke It's in Your Eyes. This is the reunion band, which is the band I want to come play the next time I have a community activity. This is really fun music. And I'm speaking with the singer, Cindy Meyer. So many big bands, you know, traditionally they're all guys, and then there's what they used to call the girl singer. So you permitted them to call you the chick singer now, okay?
I did.
The vocalist. How about that? Had you done much singing of any big band music before you started doing this?
You know, I did a little bit in high school, but really I got to kind of live the dream because, you know, I've sung everything from Messiah to church. And to be able to play in the big band with these great players and my family, it's really living the dream. Because what little girl doesn't want to sing loud with a whole band behind them?
Well, did you know some of the songs? It seems like some of them are just part of the culture.
Correct. Some of them are new to me, I'm not going to lie. But some of them I, of course, know. Like Misty, I love to sing along with that one. But I love that the way they play so well. That I wouldn't want to take that away, so I just sit back and enjoy it.
So you kind of have a unique perspective because you're the one who gets to sing the words, including the family-friendly version of Making Whoopee, which was a new one for me. How often do you have to change lyrics?
You know what? You'd be surprised that some of these are kind of racy, so we do keep it all very family-friendly.
Okay, yeah, sometimes we think, oh, lyrics have changed so much, but there have always been, let's say, metaphors.
Absolutely.
Tell us about some of these next ones. Blue Moon, Orange Colored Sky, and then the third one in the set we're going to hear.
So Blue Moon's a great one. And if you are at home in your kitchen and want to dance, this is a great cha-cha. So Okay. Grab your partner and get ready to go. Orange Colored Sky, I love it because it's just one that they can kind of wail. And I get to sing along to that one, so I think it's especially fun. And then Bye Bye Blackbird, I think you probably all will recognize the song. So you might want to sing along at home, too.
We are lucky to have a really great community band here with us. This is the reunion band. So much great music. And this next set has one I don't even know. This is, I think, the one unfamiliar one I'm going to be listening for. Blue Moon, we're going to start off with that. Richard Rogers, Lawrence Hart from 1934. Here we go.
Thank you.
coming to you live from Studio 6. This is Highway 89 with Reunion, a fabulous big band, community band here. Just real quick, we have just a minute because we want to get in lots more music, but director Dick Landerman, I've been looking at this list of all different, everybody's got some other wildly different job. What do you think is the fun of having a side gig like this?
It's an escape. I have to be honest, it's an escape from the real world. It puts us into a world where it's fun. We have a great time together. I think everybody in this band really does love each other. If that's a corny word, but I think so. I think we really do love each other, and we enjoy playing this music together.
Well, you provide a lot of fun for groups in the community, too, when you show up.
Well, I hope so. We hope so.
More music. We've got another set of three. Tell us about these next three.
Canadian Sunset, great old tune. Not that old. It was. It came out in about 1960-61. Eddie Haywood was the composer of this tune. He was a very popular lounge pianist in New York City, in Manhattan. And this is just a sweet tune. Features Boyd Ricks, our alto sax, on voice solo, baritone voice solo. He's our own version of the Velvet Fog. And then after that, we're going to pay a little tribute to the great Duke Ellington with Take the A-Train and wrap that set up with In the Mood by the Glenn Miller Band.
That's great. I think we're all set up, ready for count off Canadian Sunset with Boyd Ricks singing the solo.
Bargain for discovered you, and in your eyes I found a love that I couldn't ignore. Down came the sun. Beat my heart. I knew when that sun set, from that day we'd never part.
We'll be right back.
In the Mood, coming to you live from Reunion. Boy, Glenn Miller, and maybe the biggest hit ever in the big band era. Also, Take the A-Train and Canadian Sunset. What fun to have this community band, the Reunion Band, here in the studio. Formed more than 15 years ago at a church reunion, now drawing players young and old from all walks of life to the big happy party of big band music. Time for one more before we go. This one written in 1939 on a rainy night when composer Ari Barroso couldn't leave the house because of a storm. Homebound as he was, nothing for him to do but compose a song that the Brazilian version of the Rolling Stone magazine called the 12th greatest Brazilian song. Wherever it falls on your list, it's the traditional sign-off tune for a reunion band show, and we're happy to bring it to you as the final tune on today's episode of Highway 89. Here's the Reunion Band with Brasil. Ari Barroso's Brasil. You've been listening to the Reunion Band here on Highway 89, an eclectic assortment of professions, interests, and ages represented. They've been gathering for more than 15 years to make big band music together. What a pleasure to have them with us, and of course, our pleasure to have you listening. If you weren't dancing, you were at least tapping your toe. Either that, or you need to get a new pacemaker battery. If you just caught part of the show, want to hear the beginning, you want to listen again, or share it with a friend, easy to do. All of our shows are archived online for free on-demand listening at byuradio.org/highway89. And follow us on Twitter at BYUH89 for live show updates and special behind-the-scenes photos and video clips. Highway 89 is a production of BYU Broadcasting in Provo, Utah. Our recording engineer is Mark Waite. Our student assistants are Victoria Khalil and Naomi Campbell. Our producer is Sam Payne. I'm Stephen Cap Perry. Thanks for listening.